process of the mind getting engaged in a holistic activity is something which this pandemic robbed you from. And hence, it was very important for us to create a semblance of this in the classroom, in the online world. Now, coming to the real world that we are transitioning slowly, and of course, surely we will do this transition. Maybe it's 2 months, 3 months, or given a 6 months, but transition will take place. What is important, I think I need to answer specific that you had asked about how to create an environment where the child is effectively able to communicate her concerns. The whole thing revolves around one singular word, is to create an environment of trust and listening. Can we create this environment? Are we doing adequately in action to create this environment? This doesn't come from blackboard, that trust me, I'm your friend. These doesn't come, your actions have to speak. Parents cannot imbibe this spirit in the child to share everything with them unless they show the true listening skills and not reacting to everything that the child does, but rather contemplating and responding to the situation to help the child get out of it and grow out of it. If this process is ensured, the child will next time be more forthcoming in sharing with you, me, or anybody whom we want to entrust the responsibility. And hence, creating that comfortable line of communication, which depends solely on one word called trust and connection. Are you able to drive this connection? If you're able to drive this connection in a classroom, teacher could be the best counselor, not a counselor. But any teacher can be a best counselor if she creates this connect in the classroom. Any parent or extended family member can become a counselor equivalent if she lends the listening ear and the shoulder to the child. Are we creating this in our environment? Are we creating this in the school, which is our legal requirement, ethical requirement? And in the house, it is certainly your ethical parental responsibility. How can you not create this? Giving me best of the Leo toys is not the end of your responsibility. Helping me, and as Dr. Narjeet said, acting like a bulldozer parent and clearing the path in front of me, physical world, is not your responsibility necessarily. Okay, it ensures a little bit of safety. But helping me grow psychologically strong, mentally awake, and responsive to the changes in the environment in an emotionally balanced way is the biggest responsibility that the parents have. Are we able to drive this? If you are not able to drive this, this communication will not take place. It will be pseudo communication. And that's the reason you find children running away from home. Child cases of abuse happening right in your drawing room and you don't knowing it. The cases of your family members visiting you and engaging in the hideous tasks, hideous actions of abusing your child and you turning a blind eye it. All this is happening because you don't have the real connect with the child. And that is where you have to drop the hammer and keep hammering that, develop this connect. Don't become a parent in corporate sense. You know, employee is unhappy, give him incentive. No, that will not work with a child. That will not work with a child for long. Then the child will behave like that corporate employee who leaves in 3 years because somebody else is giving the better incentive. Hence, that emotional connect. And I come from a defense background. I come from naval background where submarining I was doing. There is one word called listen. Unless a submariner listens, he's doomed to fail. Because he has to, everything, submarines don't have eyes. They listen to the environment dangers. And from that listening, he develops the skill to say, am I in safer water? Am I in safe environment? So listen, after you listen to the child, give those comforting words. I am with you. I am there to help you out of this situation. Tell me what is your problem? What have you done and what can be done for helping you? And third thing is a reassurance. Every time a child commits something so-called legally something wrong or socially unacceptable, let's not get into the mode of judging, punishing, because the society wants you to bear your child into some ramrod child they want to create, which is not the reality. Hence, listen, comfort, reassure. I think these are the three things which have to keep repeating on. It happens, it works with everybody. It works with equally with adults. But for children, I think lending your listening ears and the shoulder they can put their hand when they want to jump across a small hurdle is the thing you have to create. So we do try. We have tried out in our schools. We try through our... So as I mentioned, every teacher in the school should be equivalent to a counselor for somebody. For somebody. Not the same teacher will be counselor for everybody. But the one teacher should be able to serve the role of a counselor, trustworthy person for at least one child in the school, not necessarily her class students or her subject students, anybody. And if you can create that environment of trust and transparency, I think children will share with you.